Your Lord will raise you to your promised station, to your promised maqam, maqam-e-mahmood. Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu asked the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam regarding maqam-e-mahmood mentioned in this verse of the Quran. The Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, "It is upon this maqam where I will intercede for my ummah, for my community on the day of judgment." Subhanallah.
Subhanallah. Subhanallah.
Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu reports, on the day of judgment, people will be as impatient as the waves at sea. Everybody on the day of judgment will go to Hazrat Adam alayhi salam and say, "You are Abu Bashar. You are Abu Bashar. Intercede for us with your Lord." Hazrat Adam alayhi salam will reply, "I am not for that. I cannot help you. Go to Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam. He is Khalilullah. He is the friend of Allah."
Subhanallah.
Everybody will go to Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam and say, "You intercede for us with your Lord." Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam will say, "I am not for that. I cannot help you. Go to Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. Wa kallama Allah Musa taklima." He will speak to Allah Azza wa Jal.
Subhanallah.
Everybody will go to Hazrat Musa alayhi salam and say, "You intercede for us with your Lord." Hazrat Musa alayhi salam will say, "I am not for that. I cannot help you. Go to Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. He is Ruhullah. He is the spirit of Allah. He is wa kalimatullah. He is the word of Allah." Everybody will go to Hazrat Isa alayhi salam and say, "You intercede for us with your Lord." Hazrat Isa alayhi salam will say, "I am not for that. I cannot help you. Go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is Habibullah.
Subhanallah.
He is the beloved of Allah." Everybody will go to the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, intercede for us with your Lord." And the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will reply by saying, Analaha, I am for this intercession. I am for this intercession.
Narae Takbir.
Allahu Akbar.
Narae Risalat.
Ya Rasulullah.
Narae Taqeed.
Achar Ya.
Narae Haidri.
Ya Ali.
Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, will you intercede for me on the day of judgment?" The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Yes, I will intercede for you." Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu asked the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Where should I seek you on the day of judgment?" The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, "Seek me at the bridge of Sirat." Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, "Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what if I cannot find you at the bridge of Sirat?" Then the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Seek me at the Mizan, the place where deeds are weighed." Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what if I cannot find you there? Then the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, seek me at the hawd, the pond. Certainly you will find me in one of these three places. The fifth quality mentioned in this hadith. Every prophet was only sent for his people, but I, Muhammad, was sent for all people.
Subhanallah.
Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Prior to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, separate prophets were sent to communities and regions for a certain duration of time. Hazrat Hud alayhi salam was sent to the people of Aad. Hazrat Salih alayhi salam was sent to the people of Thamud. Hazrat Shu'aib alayhi salam was sent to the people of Madian. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was sent to the Bani Israel, but our Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent for all people.
Subhanallah.
The prophethood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is inclusive of all generations until the last day.
Subhanallah.
Our Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is a universal prophet.
Subhanallah.
What does the Quran say? The Quran says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. O people, indeed, I am the messenger of Allah to you all. The Quran says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And we have sent you as a mercy for all the worlds. The Quran says, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَىٰ عَبَدِهِ لِيَكُونَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ نَذِيرًا. Blessed is He, Allah, who revealed the Furqan upon His beloved so that He becomes a warner of divine torment to all the worlds. The Quran says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. And oh dear messenger, we sent you to all the people as a giver of glad tidings and as a warner. The entire Quran is in praise of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The entire Quran is a na'at of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once someone asked Sayyida Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha, what is the character of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam like? She replied, don't you recite the Quran? كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. The character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Quran. For 40 years, he demonstrated the Quran through his khuluq. And for 23 years, he preached the Quran verbally.
Subhanallah.
Subhanallah. Imam Ahmad Rada Khan, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, he says, wo jo na the to kuch na tha. Wo jo na the to kuch na tha. Wo jo na ho to kuch na ho. Jaan hai wo jahan ki jaan hai to jahan hai. Imam Ahmad Rada Khan rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, everything in the universe, the ocean, the skies, nature, the heavens, everything has been created because of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You and me, we have been created because of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the galaxies have been created because of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The great Peer Meher Ali Shah Sahib rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, illustrating his love for the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, says, Subhanallah, ما اجملك ما احسنك ما اكملك. سبحان الله. Glory be to Allah عز وجل. ما اجملك. Who has created the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the most beautiful. ما احسنك. In the perfect mold. In the perfect form. In the perfect form. ما اكملك. In the most perfect mold. And the great companion, Hassan ibn Thabit, rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, in his famous poetry, he says regarding the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ahsana minka lam talaka qattu anni. My eye has never seen anyone more beautiful than you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَأَجَمَلَ مِنْكَ لَمْ تَلِدِ النِّسَاءُ. Mothers have never given birth to anyone more beautiful than you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّأً مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ. You have been created free from all defects. كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. It is as though you have been created the way you yourself desired.
Subhanallah.
Subhanallah. The birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not like the birth of any man. Why? Why is this? Why is the birth of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not like any man? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is not like you and me. Why is he different for? I will tell you why. The Quran says, قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. Allah